Maybe.
Who is the host allowed? That skinny guy. I'll kick his ass.
Ready?
Album we just put out is really great, and we're gonna run it into
famous
the dirt.
Famous Canadians,
famous ghouls, famous monsters, and there's a lot of really great stuff on there. And I think it's the most dynamic album we've done yet as far as writing.
It's kind of barbalicious.
Yeah, it is.
What?
And no, we're happy about this. I mean, this is a good point for us to get to as many kids as we can and present a good message. And the Misfits have always been that way. We've always stood for struggling and standing up for what you do. And, you know, it's really funny that 23 years into it now, at the turn of the century, we have our day. And a long time coming, and we worked hard for it, and I think we earned it.
One, two, three, four.
What's the connection, Jerry, between rock and roll and wrestling?
I think it's the same thing. I think that, you know, we train, we get up and we work out every day, and it lends itself to being in this business. I think the audience is the same. I think the excitement level is the same. I think the look is the same. So what we're trying to do is to be the first band to really get in there and bridge the gap between wrestling and rock and roll. And, you know, we have the credential to do it. We got the legacy to do it, and we got the nuts to do it. So, you know, that's pretty much what it's all about. A chill runs up your spine, crawls into your brain. The WCW has always been really technicians as far as wrestling goes, and the WWF has been more gimmicks. So what we're bringing to the party here is that the Misfits are
what do you think we're bringing?
Yeah, we're bringing to the party. We're going up against the Undertaker and the WWF, who's a friend of ours. I mean, so you know, I have nothing but respect for him. But you know, it's a small world, and there can only be one Highlander. So you know,
I'm here. I'm Canadian,
and he is Canadian.
We didn't get that.
So you know, we're working really hard to bring this kind of ghoulish image into the WCW and to be able to be a heavy hitter for them. They seem to put us in the slot up against the WWF kickoff every night on Monday, and we've been holding the ratings, and I think that the kids really appreciate having a band like the Misfits out there doing this for them.
Perry, you were with Insane Clown Posse. How badass were those flabby guys?
They're pretty much, they're the real deal. What you hear on the record is what you're going to get. Yeah, they're the real deal, for sure. I left Canada, I went to Mexico 11 years ago, and I started doing this image, not as extreme. I tried to bridge a gap in Mexico between what was rock and roll or punk rock, underground music, and the fans, because I just saw such an energetic thing. And me coming from the street, coming from real humble, our humble small family from a small town here in Canada, Thunder Bay.
Yeah, we played there.
Yeah, I won't go there. and then being influential and actually, you know, being somebody the kids see on TV and having people come up to you and talk to you and saying that, you know, what you're doing, they really dig and that makes a difference in their life. You know, me being from Canada, I think it's a real important thing because it never went to my head a lot. And I keep my feet on the ground and, I don't know. I just never looked at myself as somebody who was being famous, you know what I mean? I'm just another guy. This is a great job, and it's really cool that the kids dig what we do, and it's really cool that we're on TV and we can still keep in touch with people, you know? Spread the word.
Yeah, well,
I am Canadian.